Hello all, I'm Nikhil from iGeeks Blog, and I'm amazed by the new Mac product lineup with an Apple's new silicon chip for Mac named M1. M1 is the most powerful chip that Apple has ever created, and I guess that's what Tim said.
The M1 chip is by far the most powerful chip that we have ever created.
Okay, let's come to the point. Apple announced three different Mac with this new M1 chip. The first one is MacBook Air, second MacBook Pro 13 inches, and the third Mac Mini. Of course, we all know Mac Mini is for the user who love to work on a fixed desktop. But what about the user like me who always stick to their MacBook? Which model of MacBook should such user pick? MacBook Air or MacBook Pro? I guess we need to dig in more and understand what is the difference between these new MacBooks. But before I start comparison, I would like to request you to subscribe to our YouTube channel and press the bell icon to get notified every time we upload a new video. Now, if you have done that, let's do the comparison. First, let's talk about the MacBook Air. It has two different variants with an M1 chip. One with an 8-core CPU with 4 performance and 4 efficiency cores, 7-core GPU and 16-core neural engine. And another with the same cores of performance and efficiency, but 8 cores of GPU allowing to perform a little bit extra with a graphics and editing stuff. On the other hand, MacBook Pro 13 inches has an 8-core CPU with 4 performance and 4 efficiency cores, 8 cores of GPU and 16 cores neural engine. This means no major difference in the CPU department. If you talk about the display, both notebooks have same LED retina display as with 2560 by 1600 resolution scaled in 3 different resolutions. The major difference I notice is in the brightness, as MacBook Pro has a 500 nits brighter display while Air has a 400 nits display. Again, no major difference. But one should notice that MacBook Air has a no touch bar and only touch ID, while MacBook Pro has a touch bar with touch ID. So if you are looking forward or habitual to use the touch bar on a Mac, then the wise decision is to go for a MacBook Pro without any second thought. But if you are not, then you must continue watching this video, as the next comparison is between the battery life. Apple claims that MacBook Air has up to 15 hours of web surfing time and up to 18 hours of a video playback time with a single charge. While on MacBook Pro 13 inches, it has 17 hours of web surfing and up to 20 hours of a video playback time with a single charge, which is 10 hours more if we compare to the previous version, and all thanks to Apple M1 chip. Isn't this amazing? As now we have more powers and a freedom from the wires for a longer period of time. And talking about the charging adapter, with MacBook Air, you will get 30-watt USB-C power adapter, but if you will buy a MacBook Pro, you will get a 61-watt USB-C power adapter along with the product itself. And another minor yet noticeable change is that MacBook Air has a 3 new function keys, adding Do Not Disturb, Spotlight Search, and Dictation. These keys are replaced with the Launchpad and the Keyboard Brightness key from the older Mac. Another change that we saw on both MacBook is related to the FaceTime camera, as the new M1 chip supports the image signal processor, so you can now expect better image quality on your FaceTime calls. As of now, you may have already understood the fact that the new M1 chip is a beast when it comes to handling a day-to-day life operations. Maybe that's why Apple has removed the fan from the MacBook Air and making it Apple's first fanless MacBook. Okay, now you know what exactly are you getting offered if you would buy any of this device, but at what cost? Let's discuss that. At $999, the MacBook Air comes with 7 GPU cores instead of 8, disabling one core. But at $1249, the MacBook Air has the same 8 cores of CPU, 8 cores of GPU, and 512 gigs of SSD. Whereas for pros, the new MacBook Pro 13 inches is priced starting at $1299 and offers a one heck of a performance. Oh, that's a lot of information. And to summarize it all, I would say if you are habitual of using a touch bar on your MacBook Pro and are thinking of an upgrade, then you can go for a MacBook Pro with an M1 chip without a doubt. But if you want to taste the new M1 chip and want a great performance but also want to stick to the budget, then MacBook Air can be the device for you. And oh, one more thing that I want to tell you, for $1299, you get a MacBook Pro that has 256 gigs of SSD. But if you buy a MacBook Air for $1249, that is $49 lesser than a Pro, you will get 512 gigs of SSD. Now I hope that you have a clarity about which machine to buy for yourself. Do let me know in the comment section below which MacBook model you will be going for. And if you found this video informative, give a big thumbs up to this video and press that red subscribe button. I am Nikhil signing off. Thanks for watching. Stay safe, stay connected.